Hello, my name is Kurt Worley. I am the quantitative analyst at fxbootcamp.com. Today is Wednesday, April 29th, 2009. This is your New York session video technical briefing. It's a video review of some of the things we covered in the live class today at fxbootcamp.com during the New York session. Let me first clarify that the purpose of FX Bootcamp is education. This is not an alert service. The currency coaches do not make trade recommendations. However, we do conduct real-time technical and fundamental analysis to help you put together your trade plans throughout the day. We assume that our newer Bootcamp members are trading on a demo account so that regardless of whether or not any particular trade plan is successful, they will certainly have an opportunity to learn and eventually trade their own live accounts for years to come, both profitably and independently. What you now see is a set of three charts. These are hourly charts with daily pivot points and Fibonacci extensions of yesterday's range for three of the more heavily traded yen crosses, and these are the charts looked at 9 a.m. New York time during today's New York session. Now, the currency market has been selling the Japanese yen consistently since yesterday's London open. Now, to illustrate that, to illustrate how weak the yen has been, let's expand this pound-yen chart to sort of the price action for the past two London sessions. Now, the reason I'm showing the pound-yen chart is that of the three base currencies in the three pairs I've just shown, the Australian dollar, the euro, and the British pound were, again, the so-called base currencies of these three yen pairs. The pound has been the weakest of the three, and yet the Japanese yen has been even weaker, hence the rise in this pair since yesterday's London Open. Now, since each of these pairs reached their respective R2 pivot points about 1 hour after today's London Open, we've seen a pause in the yen selling. Now, I can think of two likely reasons for that. First, it's a basic profit take. It's basic profit taking at R2. By the way, R2, for example, on the pound yen, is this thick maroon colored line near the top of the chart. So basic profit taken in R2, that's a classic profit target on an uptrending day. Now secondly, the release of first quarter US GDP figures was scheduled for 8:30 a.m. Eastern Time. Now that's not typically a huge market mover, but this news report has a long history, which means plenty of traders will pay attention to it. Also, if there was ever a time since the Second World War when we could see a GDP number that would really spook the market, it is now. For the first quarter number, so traders may not want to be caught long going into that news release. Now, we got the news at 8:30 a.m. from Trade the News, and the actual annualized drop in U.S. GDP from the last quarter of 2008 to the first quarter of this year was an estimated 6.1%. Again, minus 6.1%, the headline number. That is worse than the expected drop of 4.7%, so it could spark some selling in the stock market, which suggests strength in the dollar and the yen. However, I told the live class just 2 minutes after the news release that there appears to be at least one positive sign from that report, a silver lining, if you will. A severe reduction in inventories was a significant contributor to that 6.1% drop in GDP. Now, that could set the stage for a rise in second quarter GDP, and that would be an encouraging sign for economists and investors alike. Markets are forward-looking. Investors are forward-looking, meaning that traders make bets today based on where they think the economy is going to be in the future. So if enough investors believe that the prospect of a positive second quarter GDP is more realistic now, given the new information from the GDP report, that would suggest continued appetite for riskier assets such as stocks. In that scenario, the Japanese yen tends to get weak, which means up for these yen pairs. Now, here's what the euro-yen charts looked like 1 hour after the U.S. GDP news. Now, technically, everything looks pretty good if you're looking to buy this pair. Seeing good separation between the major moving averages, between the 255 EMAs there, and the 55 and 21 EMAs right there. By clear evidence back here, that the overlap of the daily M4 pivot point and the 128 psychological level was a source of resistance during the Asian session. Now, that suggests this area could become a floor for price, especially after we've broken that level during the London session. Now, we've also got a Fibonacci retracement level in that 128 area as well, based on a move from the swing low here before London open to swing high there. Note the 50% retracement level of that move up at 127.97, represented by the horizontal green line. Nice overlap with the near overlap with the 128 area. Now, I should clarify that if you are bullish, you're looking to buy on dips in price to one or more sources of support, such as those I've already mentioned. And since the GDP news, we've gotten that dip in price back to 128. Now, one source of support I have not mentioned yet is a trend line, which you might find easier to see on a chart without indicators. This is a 15-minute chart showing the price action since yesterday's Asian open. And you can see from yesterday's swing low there just before London open, higher low there, and there's your pre-London open swing low there. Connect those points with a trend line, extend that forward in time, and boom, beautiful overlap with 128, and we're there now. Now, another clue to this trade setup is the clock. It's 9:30 a.m. in New York, the time for trading to open on the American stock exchanges. Now, that has been a time when we've recently seen significant increases in volatility in the equity futures markets. For example, I've got a chart for Dow futures queued up here. This is the front month contract for Dow futures showing yesterday's price action right here. Right there is the breakout move, which occurred yesterday at this time. Now, I knew that we've been seeing this kind of thing very consistently in recent trading days, but even I underestimated how consistent it's been lately. The volatility in Dow futures has increased noticeably at the U.S. equity market open on 8 of the past 9 trading days. So the odds were pretty good that the same could occur today. Okay, let's recap. The euro-yen is retesting both previous resistance and an uptrend support line, and the yen has been weak since yesterday's London open. Now, actually, if you were in the live class, you might have thought that I didn't sound overwhelmingly bullish on the yen crosses. Now, during the last hour of my London lunch session today, I told the live class that I wanted to dig into some of the other details from the US GDP report to see if there were any other glimmers of hope beyond the inventory numbers I just mentioned earlier. Now, when I ended my session, that's exactly what I did. I downloaded the GDP report from the Bureau of Economic Analysis website, the BEA, compiles the GDP report. Here's a copy of the spreadsheet from the website showing the most recent GDP report. And the first sub-item in the first table of the GDP report spreadsheet is personal consumption expenditures. That's U.S. consumer spending, and it rose an estimated 2.2% from the previous quarter compared to drops on the prior two quarters. Now, that doesn't guarantee that the worst is over for the U.S. economy, but it is a positive sign for now, and the markets seem to be responding lately more and more to good news than to bad news. And now that stock traders have had an hour or so to digest the GDP report, the stage could be set for a rally at the open of U.S. equity markets. And as I mentioned earlier, that usually means up for the yen pairs. And now that I've seen another silver lining in the GDP report per se, I'm more comfortable with buying the euro-yen. Now, the chart I used to pinpoint an entry after the bounce at the 128 level was the 1 minute chart. Here's the 1 minute chart shown a few minutes after the U.S. equity market opened. Now, during this rise in price here, the first meaningful bounce from 128, I was reviewing the GDP report, and then I noticed this series of lower highs right through here, including this most recently formed swing high right there at 128.25. Seems like a trend line is what worked there, so I drew up a trend line. And I waited. I decided to wait until a trend line break before going long. A few minutes later, we get it. Now that we've got a trend line break, I would prefer to go long on a retest of that trend line. That trend line has been previously a source of temporary resistance. Now it could become support. Basic role reversal that occurs with the horizontal support and resistance and with trend lines. Now, I would prefer to go long after on the retest of the trend line, especially if it overlaps with the Fibonacci retracement level of the rise up from 128. Now, if I see an overlap there, a Fib level and trend line retest, even better. Let me draw the FIP study I'm referring to here. Moving forward in time. There we go. That's where I got in. 128.20. Look how much time we spend at 128.20. The year-end spends nearly 5 minutes hovering at that level. Trendline retest, 38.2% retracement of the move up from 128. Now, you don't need razor-sharp reflexes to grab an entry like that. My exit strategy was simple. Exit the trade for a small loss if price dipped a few pips below 128. And about 10 minutes later, the euro-yen is 30 pips higher. Great time to move that stop loss to the break-even point, but not more than that, not more than that. And this was the key to the trade. Let me show you what I mean. This is a 3-minute chart for the euro-yen, showing the price action pretty much since today's London Open. Now, that recent rise in the euro-yen from 128 took us to a level near today's highs, which saw all kinds of choppy price action during today's London session. Now, I'm anticipating some kind of reaction to that area near 128.60. Now, where the euro-yen drops in price from near today's highs. Now, I'm hoping that the euro-yen can establish a higher low at a logical source of support, then continue to rally up above and beyond today's high at 128.65. Now, what I want to do is establish where that source of support might be, then keep my stop loss below that. Now, I'm showing a 3-minute chart with that indicator because it tells a story, at least it tells me a story, about a level that just might serve our purpose. Notice how many times 128.30 has been both resistance and support since London Open. And the euro-yen just broke above that level again a few minutes ago. So now that level could become support. And we could also get a little help from Fibonacci as well. Note the near overlap of the 50% retracement of the bounce off from 128. To the swing high here, just above 128.50. That 50% retracement level, represented by the horizontal green line, perched very close to 128.30. So there's two technical reasons I can see why 128.30 would protect me. So I left my stop at my entry 128.20, and I'm thinking all or nothing here, all or nothing. Either I get stopped out of break even or I score. Now, I do give up some modest profits from time to time doing this sort of thing, but I also get some solid wins. Check this out. 128.30 holds. There's a higher high for the day. And unfortunately, we double topped there. Now, the bad news is the euro-yen is still stuck near the London session high at 128.65, and London close is just about a little more than 45 minutes away. Profit-taking my London traders could push this pair back down. The good news is that we're still seeing higher lows. Starting from here, higher low, which I already mentioned at 128.30, and there's yet another higher low right there. And by the way, my stop loss, I've got my stop positioned here right now. My stop is there, a few pips below that higher low at around 128.45. So I do have some profit at hand at this point while still giving this trade a little more time to unfold. And boom, let me zoom in a little bit here. The market really came to life during the final 40 minutes of the session. I held on, then took profit at 129.30, which we retried in here. I took profit at 129.30 for two reasons. Let's go back to the 15-minute chart where I explain why. Do you remember that uptrend support line we just drew on the 15-minute chart a little bit earlier? That uptrend support line is one piece of a channel. There's the guideline for the channel. And the euro-yen reaches an overlap an overlap of the top of that channel and last week's high, represented by this horizontal black line near the top of the chart. It reaches the combination of those levels just before the London close, which I've got represented here by the vertical red line. Now, I've got a four-hour chart, which shows how I identified that resistance level at 129.30. Note that the swing low here from about 2 weeks ago, that swing low right there, and last week's swing high right there are both very close to 129.30. So in at 128.20, out at 129.30, 110 pips in profit. Good stuff. Again, my name is Kurt Worley, and this has been your New York session video briefing from fxbootcamp.com for Wednesday, April 29th.